So those guys that said they can't afford MIC, too expensive. How expensive are your shoes? I bet you it cost more than my shoes. And I bet you I made more than money than you today. Knock on wood, I'm just joking around. But that's the fact, guys. You have to prioritize what is important in your life. People say, oh, it's too expensive. You fucking, you're cutting costs. I see people trying to join like these fucking $50 Discord chat rooms. I mean, what the fuck are you doing? You're learning from a bunch of idiots. Because you can't pay another $100 a month. But then you're woe now and you're wasting all your fucking money on Hennessy. Well, if you can afford Hennessy, you can do it. But, you know, don't complain that you can't afford it. You know, wasting money on dumbass shit like fucking brand name clothes. I hate brand name clothes, man. Seriously. I mean, the only reason people are buying the fucking $500 t-shirt that says Gucci on it. What the fuck? In Vietnam, that shit's on a Hanes underwear shirt that says Gucci. I can buy that shit for like $2. And you can't fucking afford it. Once you learn how to day trade, guys, fuck buying the Gucci shirts. I'm looking to buy Gucci. I'm buying the company. Shit like that. Buying shares of the company. You know, that's the next level up, guys. Stop making other people rich. Make these fucking Gucci guys rich. What the fuck is this Gucci shit? But you know what, man? People like brand names because it makes them feel good. Makes them look like they're rich, but they're really poor. Anyways, I won't get into that. I can rent on that shit all fucking day. But when I look at my fucking shoes and they cost me $80, and I'm seeing a bunch of broke guys out there with Yeezys on, with fucking limited edition Air Jordans, telling me that they cannot afford to join MIC. Can you give me a discount? I'm broke. You're broke because of your mentality. I'm going to teach you how to join MIC for free today. Okay? Today is all about how to prioritize your life. How to basically get the most out of MIC. How to join MIC for pretty much for free, guys. The members are in MIC right now. They're using the watch list. But before we get that, let's talk about the webinar real quick. Tomorrow is Tosh's webinar. It's a free webinar. It's like an hour long. And Tosh posts it every tomorrow. You'll see it. It's free. We post it on every single Wednesday, guys. Every single Wednesday, we call it new member orientation. But the new member orientation, actually, we changed it now to be a lot more than just a new member orientation, man. I started to attend weekly now with Tosh because I kind of love it. I do live trading. I teach channel trading. I do live. This is the only time that you see live trading for me and all that stuff. You know, for free, guys. Just, you know, I want people to see what we do. Because I'm having fun, man. The key is I have so much fun at Tosh's webinar that I decided to go back every week. Before, I was just kind of like, just for fun. I just watch it. But now I'm having so much fun, and it's been a tradition that, and to be, knock on wood, I've been making money every single, knock on wood, I'm going to fucking jinx myself. These live trading has been very prosperous for myself. So why not, right? Why not educate and make some money during the webinar that Tosh does tomorrow? 2 p.m. market time. It's going to be on YouTube at our YouTube channel, My Investing Club on the YouTube channel. Every Monday, Alex does a YouTube live around 11 a.m. I do mine on Instagram at 11:15. Joe Kelly does a large cap and options webinar for 2 hours on Tuesdays, which is tonight. If you join tonight, you get to see it. Every Tuesday, guys, Joe Kelly does, you know, a large cap for the large cap guys and options. And then Thursday night, Aloha Austin does his strategy webinar on Thursdays at 7 p.m. Same thing with Joe. Joe does it at 7 p.m. So, dude, we have so many ways for you to learn every single day of the week. And then Saturday, we have weekend mentoring every other week, too, to review charts. And then there's lifetime only events. So my God, man, I mean, so when you're talking about MIC is too expensive, Jesus Christ, man, these other motherfuckers, all they do is they come into the room 2 minutes before the open, pump you positions and leave. They're teaching you anything, they only teach you how to fucking be a sheep. So when you say MIC is expensive, fuck yeah, we're the Harvard. You want fucking Harvard education of trading? Or do you just want a fucking online degree? You know? That's the difference. You can go to these fucking chumps that don't know what the fuck they're doing and then pay cheap price. You get what you pay for, man. But we give you the greatest value, guys. And I just don't know what else to do anymore. I'm not going to negotiate on price. I'm not going to... You get what you pay for, guys. I'm not going to be the Hyundai Excels of the world. We're keeping to the Ferrari. We are priced as a Ferrari, but you know what, man? To be honest, we're not priced as Ferrari. We are the Ferrari, but priced very inexpensively. And for $200, guys, a month, dude, we give you the watch list. The watch list is meant to do two things. I'll show you how to use the watch list, okay? So the obvious way to use the watch list is to follow the trade plans. And members today have followed the trading plans and made money. Not only are they making money, dude, they're making their whole membership in one day. You can basically do this. I've been making fucking lifetime every fuck. Not gonna win. I don't want to jinx myself. You know, this is the process that Alex and I use. Other members they use. JJ has been using this. Oh my god, dude! I've been posting his P&Ls every day. It's insane. Today's up like $4,000. The other day was like $9,000, $10,000. I think it was up like 20-something thousand the other day. I'm like, dude, think about that. That's life-changing money. And how was he able to do that? James was able to do that not because I'm fucking giving him plays. He's not copying my plays. He's learning the process. The process fucking works. Okay? Learn the fucking process. We teach you to become a self-sufficient trader. There's nobody out there, guys. I'm telling you right now, that teaches you to be a self-sufficient trader. There's nobody out there that does not pump like we do. We do not pump at all. We put out a watch list. That's as close to pumping as we can get. Which is not really pumping. It's giving you our guidelines, our trading plans. And you think about this. Today, VTSI. I posted on Twitter. Alex posted on his fucking watch list. Same thing. We shorted the $8.50, $9 line. Boom. Money. The problem is this. VTSI was $7. Can you have the discipline to wait for your lines? That's part of the process. Our process fucking works. The problem is we as the trader fucks up. We mess up because of FOMO, greed, chasing, whatever it may be, self-doubt, fear. And so you're like $7 right now. It's broken, Bao. It's broken. Why can't I slam the bid? Because I'm like, dude, it's going to freaking trap. I know this. This is part of the process. And so I'm waiting at the $9 line. You saw my prints on Twitter, guys. You see my prints every day of my trading chart. You know, we know how these things run because I have experience. Alex has experience. Our members have experience. And we help guide you guys, right? And so even if we give you guys the best trading plans, the best strategies, the best everything, most people fail because they cannot have the discipline to wait. To wait for that 850 line to start shorting. They're shorting at $7. And by the time $8 comes, they're blown out. They're stopped out. And I'm just sitting here waiting for all those guys to stop out at the $9 line. Okay? So I'm sitting looking at my chart, man. I'm sitting there. Sell, 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 sell. Every time it hits, I feel it drops down. Okay? I don't cover yet because I know the area I want to cover. Take a look at my chart once again. It goes back to $9. Boom. I'm shorting again. I have no fucking fear. Because why I don't have a fear? Because a couple things. I trust my system. I trust my process. What's the worst that I can do? I lose? People are afraid. It's because they're afraid to blow up. They're afraid of the unknown. You know what we always tell people? Pre-define your risk. We're the only rare ones that teach you risk management, guys. I'm not fearful because we tell you to put the hard stop in. If you're short in the $9 line, put a hard stop in at $9.50, something like that. At least you would not be scared because you know what the maximum you're going to lose. We always say size down, widen your stops. So put 1,000 shares out there, okay? You can take a 30-cent loss if you want. But the fact that if you take a 30-cent loss on 1,000 shares, that's $300. If that's scary, size down, do 500 shares. You know, do 200 shares. You're scared because a couple of things, of the unknown. You can mitigate the unknown by predefining your risk. Know where you're gonna take the loss. Know how much money you are going to take the loss. That's it, Hulse. Well, fuck. Oh, unless a fucking meteor hits your fucking face too, but you know, shit happens, bro. You know, that you can't mitigate every fucking risk. You know, if you want to fucking, if you want to be safe, join the monastery, dude. Even joining the church nowadays is not safe. You got fucking priests raping little boys, right? So, what the fuck, dude? That's life, bro. The point is this, though. You can tell which one halts because you use a certain trading platform that tells you the halt before it comes. Okay? I know before a halt comes. And I see it on my DOS Trader platform before it halts. I can exit if I wanted to. Today, VTSI halted at the $7.70 line or something like that. And I was okay with that. I wanted it to halt. I wanted to halt so that people get all anxious and then they build up and they boom. And so we know how to make these risks. So if you are still scared, it means you're sizing too large. Size down, guys. Size down, widen your stops. And you know what, man? Part of trading is being able to take a loss. If it's like learning martial arts, judo, whatever it is, the first thing they teach you is how to properly fall. Taekwondo, karate, they teach you how to properly take a hit without getting knocked out. Same thing with trading, guys. In trading, it's like a boxer, man. If you want to become a boxer, you must be okay with getting hit in the face. But you roll with the punches. You don't get knocked out. You roll with the punches. This is the same thing with doing hard stops, guys. You roll with the punches. And you size accordingly. It's not going to halt and open up like $25 higher. It may, but shit, that's life. But if you're going to be scared of that happening, which is a true black swan, then might as well not trade. But you know what? You have ways to mitigate all that. You set up your max daily loss at the broker level. And that's all you do. This is why we tell people to take out their money. You know, I make money, I take it out every week. And so, you see the P&Ls that Alex and I make, guys? We don't have millions of dollars in our account. I think I had like $45,000 account today because I didn't take my money out yet. I made money yesterday and the day before, so I didn't take my money out. But I usually reset my money back down. And so the money you see me making is like 8% of my account. Per account. I trade with two accounts, one bigger account, but you see, man, I can make that money every day. So the money you see me making, $6,000, $10,000 a day, it may not sound a lot to the normal individual. It's because these other guys are trading with millions of dollars. I see guys with a $10 million position trying to scalp 50 cents. You know, they're bragging about being in $16 million positions and to make $100,000. I mean, dude, I'm not going to risk $16 million to make $100,000, you know? So that's the thing people don't want to see. People just look at the P&Ls. I don't like to post P&L because it's arbitrary, guys. Take a look at the charts. Why am I the only one posting a chart on Twitter? I'm the only one that posts a chart every single fucking day. Every day. I do fine. You can tell if I make money or not by my charts. The point is the education that I value, guys. I value how to properly trade. I am trying to change the industry, which I think I have. Before I launched an MIC, before we launched an MIC, everyone's using moving average, all that. No one's using lines. You remember they used to make fun of the lines and the zombie rule? Now everyone's talking about the zombie rule and the lines, right? They're like, oh, zombie, you paint people to fucking draw lines. It's not just the drawing lines. It's how to use the application. How to use that knowledge of the zombie to profit from both a short seller and a long bias trader. I love the zombie hour, to be honest. I'm waiting for broken stocks to bounce during the zombie hour so I can short them. And I tell my guys all day long about that. And I teach guys in MIC how to profit from the zombie rule, the 3 p.m. rule, and the reversal hour rule, things like that. So when you see the watch list that we provide, guys, the watch list that Alex provides usually a short seller. So when he's talking about VTSI, $8.50, okay, as a long bias trader, you know you should be selling there. You should take some money off the table. So what happened today? I see a chat room guy pump VTSI. He was down a ton of money. He was the only one that got out. His whole room got bagged. His whole room got backholed because they don't understand these things that we're teaching. They don't understand resistance and support and the proper lines and the idea of easy to borrow. They are all fucked up. They're just falling as sheep. They're chasing this guy's alerts, but they don't understand that they are the ones that are moving his trades. And so as a long bias trader, some people went long. I think Alex went long at VTSI. Okay, you go long at VTSI knowing that they're gonna get pumped up, right? But where do you sell? These guys that hold onto VTSI lost their ass. So how do you use the watch list? Even though the watch list is short sellers information, you know where I am shorting, where Alex is shorting, where the professional real shorts are entering. Because I would like to consider myself a real short seller, a professional. I hate using that term, but you know, I'm as close as a professional as a retail can get, right? Even though I'm in my underwear and shit walking around. But the key is VTSI. You use that. If you're a short seller, easy. You just follow the trading plans. If you are a long bias trader, you see those numbers. So if you are in that stock, guys, you know where to exit. That's the key. You cannot lock in, you cannot profit from a stock until you sell. Fuck diamond hands. Diamond hands have fucking turned to dust. These guys are diamond hands on GME, AMC, although they went bankrupt. Even Dave Portnoy, he lost like $1 million or some shit on that, right? It fucking diamond hand my ass. Fuck the diamond hand. I own the diamond mine. You know, fuck the diamond hand. When I own the diamond mine and I'm fucking pumping out as many diamonds as you want, diamonds could be worthless right now. You know, diamonds are produced in a laboratory right now. You know, you can't even tell real diamonds anymore. They're coming out with clones that are so fucking good. So use the watch list if you're a long bias trader to know where to take your fucking position out. Fuck the diamond hands. Forget the diamond hands. Take your money, dude. That stock went up to the resistance, VTSI, $9. Dude, and then it tanked back down like $1.50 to $7.50. That's where I covered. Shorted $9, covered down to the $7.50 line. That's $1.50, guys. That's a lot of money. So, you know, longs profit by knowing where to sell. And I warned all the time, like yesterday, SEAC. Before it popped out, I warned the members. I'm a short seller. I'm like, be careful about this. I am covering, taking my loss, because this thing is going to pop. So the moment that happened, a lot of members went long and made money. Same thing with PFMT today. Take a look at my chart. I covered it. I did well in that stock, but then I noticed something weird. It was weird. It was not going back down anymore. And so from experience, I'm reading the tape. I'm doing all this stuff. And I'm like, dude, this is not a short anymore. So you take a look at what I covered, 208, 209. And then it spiked up to 250. Literally, guys, 30 seconds after I covered. I warned the guys in the room. I covered. Be careful about shorting this stock. And then, boom, it spikes up. So, because I'm a short seller, you're like, how do I take advantage of that if I'm a long bias trader? You take advantage by doing the opposite of what I'm doing. Right? If I'm shorting at that line, sell at that line. If I'm covering at that line, go along that line. And that's how we work together, because I also go long, guys. When there's opportunities, I go long. It might be probably a fucking pretty good long, because I don't go as long nearly as enough as I go short. But when I go long, such as the first bounce, it's dead on, dude. It's dead on. That's because a long is nothing more than a buy, right? And a buy is nothing more than a cover. I cover my, I long all day long, guys. When I cover a stock, I go long, right? I buy, a buy is a buy, a sell is a sell. It doesn't matter if it's long, short, whatever. A buy is a buy, a sell is a sell. And so the watch list itself has been invaluable. Couple reasons. Number one, of course you make money off it. Knock on wood. You follow it, you should be making money. When you don't make money, stop out. We tell you where the risk is, you stop out, and it's a risk-reward ratio, right? But more importantly, guys, as a beginning trader, you use the watch list to learn. Learn how Alex draws these lines. Learn his mentality of choosing the stock. Alex has done the work for me already. Dude, I've been getting lazy, I admit. Not lazy, but I live in California, man. It's so hard to wake up, man. And so I wake up later now. And then when I wake up too late, guys, I go and see Alex's watch list. I go, he has already scanned the market for me. So if you want to be fucking lazy, you join MIC just for the watch list. He scanned the market for me already. He already picked out the stocks. He picked out the ones that he thinks is the best trades of the day. Okay? And so if you want to learn, reverse engineer the watch list. Try to come up with your own watch list to see how you can draw the lines, to see how he's able to pick those stocks. And that is the key to self-sufficiency. Self-sufficiency is just not chasing like a sheep. These other rooms, they're screaming out fucking trades, and these guys, and the members are chasing sheep. No wonder they don't lose. If I had 2,000 members chasing every fucking shit I do, oh my God, I can't fucking manipulate that shit as much as I want. They're bragging about making money. I see other Discord chat rooms, it's even worse, dude. They're doing the exact opposite of what we teach. They're buying when the stock is dead. That's because they have 100,000 members, sheep. I don't even call them members anymore, 100,000 sheep. Doing whatever. And they're buying it, they're the first guy buying it. No shit, they're making money. They must be a moron to lose money. Right, guys? I'm like, but you know what, man? I love it. Man, when they pump a dead stock, you know who's on the other side of the trade waiting at the right lines that we teach? I'm fucking like, pump it, baby. Pump this dead stocks. Pump this fucking shit up. I'm there shorting at the appropriate time. And they're like, what the fuck? Members are losing. They don't care. They just see the main pumper guy make money. And they go, and so what he did, I'm going to tell you, I used to be one of those guys. When I started trading, I thought all moderators knew what the fuck they were doing. All pumpers knew what they did. No, wrong. Wrong. So I was, you know what I did when I started trading? I made it a point to be the fastest sheep in the house. When I lose, I never blame the fucking manipulator. I blame myself because I was too fucking slow. Wow, you're too slow. I need a better computer. Okay, I got a faster computer. Oh shit, I can't type in the numbers about it. I'm gonna start using hotkeys. I'm gonna start using fucking hotkeys. Because hotkeys is gonna give me that fucking edge. And you notice, one of the biggest fucking pumpers on the game right now, he stopped talking about hotkeys. There's a reason. He started learning how to trade through MSC. He don't need hotkeys anymore. He's doing the exact opposite of what he used to do. I used to fucking take his money left and right. Now he's actually more intelligent. But the point is, you know, that's the beauty. We need both sides of the team, guys. We are the guys that are patient waiting, and we need someone to pump idiots up. And I'm not here to fucking take anybody's money that in that fashion, right? So, but you notice he stopped using hotkeys. He stopped using fucking moving averages. He's top talking about these doji candles. He's just talking about lines and levels. And we have revolutionized the trading game, guys. Made it super simple. People are not using hotkeys anymore because I bashed the shit out of that. And so that's why I started. When I started, I was like, dude, I'm doing all these dumb shit because I wanted to be the fastest sheep. I wanted to be the fastest sheep. I didn't realize that I was still sheep. Being the fastest sheep is still sheep. I want to become my own day trader, self-sufficient day trader, understood what I do, and that's what MIC does. All these guys in MIC, I love it, man. I'm seeing James, I'm seeing all the moderators. They're making consistent money, and not because I'm telling them what to do. They're learning. We all start the same, guys. We all have to have a great mentor. We all have to, but the thing is this, guys. You can only be as good as your strategies. The problem is this, to get a working strategy that's proven, you can't get it from a newbie. The strategies that I teach, that we teach, that Alex teaches at MIC, we've been training for a long time. And these are proven strategies that I've fucking done for decades. All right, the first red day rule, that was mine from the OTC days. The 3-day rule, things like that, guys. The first resistance, the first bounce, all those are proven strategies. If you're chasing the wrong strategy, you're fucked. You can be 100 years on a losing strategy. Okay, so that's the thing you gotta be careful about. These new guys coming up, guys, they're trading for a year. You have to understand how they're making their money. They're making the money through pumping. Stocks only go up, right, guys, until it goes down, right? And so you have to be very careful, guys, to learn the right strategy. Because you know what, man? If you ask yourself, this is the test. This is the FUBU test. If you strip away all of their followers, if you strip away their chat room, if you strip away their ability to pump, will they still be profitable? That's the key, guys. I don't need anybody to pump to make my money. You don't even know what I'm in until I'm exiting. That is the beauty. Look at this. No one knows what I'm in until I fucking exit. That is a true day trader. Not someone who front loads, low floats. Where their strategies only to hit low floats because they have 1,000 sheep moving low floats. Is that a strategy that you can fucking live on? No, you cannot. If the SEC comes and busts them one day, you're toast. You just spent 5 years of your life paying this guy tens of thousands of dollars to learn a bullshit strategy that does not work. Okay, guys? So you can color it, whatever. But that's the thing. We're not flashy. And sometimes it pisses me off, seriously. It pisses Alex and I off. We work so damn hard because we truly want you guys to learn. And sometimes we're like, dude, should we just become a FUBU? You know how much more money I can make just by selling alerts? You don't think everybody wants to learn my trades? I can fucking charge whatever the fuck I want. Live trade. I can set up a live trading account. Maybe I'll do that. You want to join? $1,000 a month, motherfucker. $1,000 a month. You can watch me fucking live trade. $1,000 a month. All I need is a few guys to make $1 million. Right? Think about that. $1,000 a month. Oh, I only need 100 guys. I'm pretty sure there's more than 100 guys that would pay me $1,000 to copy my trades, guys. But this is the thing people don't understand. People go, the trolls are trolling me daily. There's a reason they're trolling me. Okay? They're not trolling these other motherfuckers. They're trolling me. Because I'm the guy that knows what they're doing. But so sometimes I think, the trolls, the competitor. And they always say this, guys. They always say, Bao, this is their only argument. Bao, if you make so much money, why do you need to charge? Motherfucker. Jeff Bezos makes a shit ton more than anybody in the world. Why is he still working at Amazon? Why isn't Amazon free? Why should it be fucking free? I want to make money. This is capitalism. Go, you want communism free shit? Go vote for Bernie Sanders. Go move to Venezuela. Go move to China. They're communist country. Shit's free. This is capitalism. That's the funny part. These guys are trading stocks. Stocks is the epitome of capitalism. And they're questioning, why am I charging? I could charge a lot more, guys. Seriously, I could charge a ton more. And the way I do it, the reason is, think about this, guys. I was doing well for a long time. I've taught a lot of great traders. I am the guru's guru, right? I am your mentor's mentor. There's a reason why I started to do this, and with the right people like Alex and Tosh, right? Is because I'm so sick of the industry, guys. I'm so fucking sick of the industry, so I launched this thing. Piss a lot of people off. It pissed a lot of people off, you know? But I still do it the right way. I do it the right way. If I want to make money, guys, it's guaranteed. I'll do live trading. I'll sell alerts. And I'll make a fucking shitload of money. I'll make a ton of money. I wouldn't post my charts. Why am I posting my charts for free? I would just post P&L. I would grow my room. You know? I would start a free Discord chat room. The reason that this Discord chat room don't charge is because they have 100,000 sheep. They need sheep. They need dumb sheep. They're not there to educate. We are there to educate. By education, we need money to pay for education. We're not here to pump. That's why I have to charge. Think about that, man. These free Discord room, they don't do shit except pump their playbook. These guys that are fucking in charge of these Discord chat rooms, I'm like, holy shit, they don't know what the fuck they're doing. No shit, they're fucking not charging. They're not charging because they have unintelligent sheep. The most scary thing that we can do as humans, as a leader, as a human, I consider each of us as, let's say, our own separate country, right? MIC is our own separate country. If I was scared, I would never educate. This is why women was never educated when they're young. There's these countries that women don't get a chance to vote. They can't work. They can't do it because they're scared. The leaders are scared of uprising. Once people understand, they're going to uprise and go, hey, it's not fair treatment. But we are here educating our members, and they're still here. You don't hear anything bad about MIC. We want them to learn. I always tell people, we rule by love and not by fear, guys. People love MIC. They don't fear us. What they fear is these other chat rooms, because these other chat rooms are their means of making money. Imagine if these free chat rooms have no members. If, you know, the pump rooms, things like that. So I want to educate everybody. By educating everybody, it actually, if I'm doing things wrong, guys, you guys will know. You guys will leave. You guys will hate me. You gotta bow, motherfucking bow. I'm teaching you guys all the tricks that these scammers do. They buy low floats across the week. They identify one stock. Make so they usually do this. So a stock gets pumped up, boom, 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 and it dies off, and people forget about it. So they're accumulating across 3 days, a solid position. They're waiting, and then what they do is they're gonna tell their friends first, their moderators, their friends, and their friends accumulate. So now they have a team of guys accumulating that stock, and because they're so low, they can put support in. They're putting bid support in, and then they're pumping it to their members. And why do you think these fucking guys get pumped? You think they really give a fuck about helping you make money? Why did not they not alert you 3 days ago when they're accumulating? Why did they only alert you when the stock parabolics up? And they're like, oh, my average is low. You think in your head, how the fuck you get that average? Oh, I held that shit since last week. Oh, I had that shit forever. You know, you think about that, man. And I hate that game, guys. I fucking hate that game. So my goal is to educate everybody so the masses can rise up and revolt against the evil empire, I call it. There's an evil empire out there. Same thing with broker. Look at how cheap locates are now. I think I have a great deal to do with that. MIC has helped the locate game get very cheap. You know what I'm saying? So think about this, man. You think I pay for my own locates, guys. Cobra doesn't give me free locates. I pay for my commission. Cobra does not give me no fucking free commission. I pay retail the same thing as you do, guys. There's a reason I do that. No one can buy me. You think you can buy me for a free locate? Fuck no. And I keep the integrity of both sides. So that you know, if you join Cobra, guys, if you join our system, we're not taking advantage of you. We are there to fucking help you make money. Same thing with the moderators. You can ask the moderators in our room, guys, right? We have a mod chat, but that's just to discuss the members and how to keep the you know, administration going. It's not to pump stocks. If you ask every moderator, they think there's a secret club. There's no secret club, right, guys? Who's the moderator? James, you there, JJ? There's no fucking secret member. I don't even talk to fucking Tosh, by the way. Tosh doesn't know what stocks I trade. And neither is Alex now. Alex is my tab. We just know the tickers that we're going to hit. And during that, it's too fast, guys. If you ask Alex, me and Alex don't even talk like during the training day because we know how each other trades. You know, I mentored Alex to the point where Alex is basically like a better version of me. Okay? I want my guys to be better than me, guys. I am the first generation, guys. I want everybody to be better than me. So that's how it is. So, it's been a long time since I've ranted about this, but it's gonna come. It's gonna come when the market's gonna correct itself. We've been in a 13, 14 year bull market. And so, it's gonna come when the stock market's gonna start crashing down. It has to. And who's left, guys? I guarantee you, it's not gonna be the Discord room, guys, who's a pumping. It's gonna be the guys at MIC licking their chops, realizing that they spent the past year learning and struggling. They think they're struggling, but it's not. It's the genius behind the madness to force you to learn, to force you not to have a fucking cheat sheet, force you not to copy my homework. Copying homework is copying trades, guys. Look at Davin. You there? See, all these guys, JJ, right, guys? Look at JJ. It was very difficult, but dude, he's kicking ass. He's doing better than me on many days. I love it. He learned the right way. You know what I'm saying? He's learning the right way. And if you talk to every MIC member, guys, we don't pump our positions, man. We don't pump our positions. And this is bizarre to some people. But you know what, man? Not everybody's created the same, guys. I want people to be... It's not a right to be inside MIC. We kicked out a lot of bad people out in MIC. I don't I treat online as if it's my friends on the outside world. I don't have many fucking friends on purpose, because they're all fucking backstabbers or whatever it may be, right? Look at me, man. I'm a very different individual. Good or bad, it's who I am. I have my certain sort of integrity about certain things and about certain things not, but you know, you want the right mixture in the community, otherwise it spoils it. So we kicked a lot of guys out who complain about us not giving out alerts. Some guy goes, I want to join. I joined because I thought you were going to give me out alerts. I wanted to be sit by you, Metro. I'm like, what the fuck is your problem, motherfucker? You paying me fucking $200 and you want to fucking suck on my dick? I mean, no offense, but it's like, dude, you could done for free if you're a girl, but no, I'm joking. But okay, we should get there. We need HR for that. But anyways, you guys get the point, man. I want to keep this nice and short, but I'm going to summarize real quick, guys. It's a very simple process to make money trading. Very simple. But simple doesn't mean easy. If you fucking have the discipline to listen to what I said. You know what, man? This is a very thing. If I tell you, study your ass off, within 2 years, I can make you rich. Most people would not do it. They go party, go fuck, it's 2 years too long. That's the thing. That's the thing with trading and MIC, guys. Give me 1 to 2 years, I guarantee you. If you follow and become disciplined, you will be rich. Look at JJ, look at all the moderators, guys. Every guy that's in my MIC sees that. They're coming out. The beauty, I know how it works, is because when I post my charts, guys, there's 5 other, 10 other members posting the similar charts, if not better charts. They know how to enter, they know how to exit. Look at Stefan. Where's this guy? So the moderators, the junior moderators, they learn as like I promote them as they learn our system. And I'm telling you, our system fucking works, guys. The watch list is fucking gold, you know? But people don't use it enough. People use it in the wrong way. So give me that year, guys. I will teach you. It's not easy. Simple does not mean easy. But I've taught a lot of motherfuckers to become millionaires. In MIC as well. I don't brag about that like other people, because the guys, I mean, dude, I've taught... I mentor mentors. I'm their mentor's mentor, right? But anyways, but that's what I'm going to end it here, guys. Hit up Tosh tomorrow. We have a free webinar. If you're interested in MIC, if you're interested in changing your life, if you're interested in becoming rich, I hate using that word. There's many reasons to become rich. Rich through friendship, whatever. We have a great community, guys. If you need a job in MIC, not MIC, don't ask for a job in MIC, but we have guys who are engineers, doctors, lawyers, whatever, in your field, you know, become friends. That's what After Hours MIC is about. I created that as a social network. Instead of going to Facebook, Tinder, all that bullshit, meet like-minded, goal-oriented, good, solid people to become friends with at MIC. They're great guys at MIC. That's why we keep the price where we do. It sets a minimum bar. I don't want these fucking tar-kicking cheap fucks. I'm so sick of those guys. Those guys are not worth my time. Seriously, if you're a cheap fuck over $50, don't come see me. Because I'm not that type of guy, guys. I'm a very generous guy. I get drunk, as you guys know, get free walk. I don't give a fuck. That's who I am. I want friends like that around our community, guys. So tomorrow, free webinar, 2 p.m. If you're serious, text Tosh, okay? Text Tosh, he will help you today. Tell them you want to become rich. You want to help your family. You want to change your... Take a look at the Instagram testimonials, guys. Families' lives have been changed. And that's the reason why we do this. Yes, MIC is the country club for the everyday man. Where the fuck does a guy like me... Hey, you fucking meet a guy like Alex and that. He makes millions of dollars, right? I hate bragging about myself. So I always love to brag about other people. But where the fuck would you be able to meet people like us? To be honest, we're good people, but you wouldn't know. You wouldn't even know. I have people say, hey, Bal, you know, you're like a rock star to me, and I feel weird because I'm like, I'm just a normal guy. But Alex and I, so Alex, I'm going to end it with this good story, guys. I'm going to end it with a very good story that Alex said. So Alex was feeling good. He went to a restaurant, and this person from Spain, barely speaks English, just came over. He was really nice to Alex. He let him stay when the restaurant was closed. So Alex gave him a big tip. You know, he only ordered a little meal, but he gave him like a $200 tip. He gave him a $200 tip. And the guy was so grateful. And then Alex came back the other day. Just yesterday, he came back to the same restaurant. And the guy started following Alex on Instagram. Right, my business club. And Alex is just making, Alex made like 10 G today. So, but yesterday he only made like $1,000. And sometimes we forget, $1,000 for a normal guy is a lot of money for working 1 hour. So Alex was feeling kind of bummed out. I underperformed. Alex was crying. I'm like, fuck, man. In my head, like, we are too spoiled, guys. When making $1,000 in 1 hour is crap. We have to get over that mentality. So the guy was like, oh my God, Alex, you traded amazingly yesterday. Because the guy is a server in a small town in New Jersey. He's probably making $200 working his butt off a day. And that's a good day. $200 is a good day. And then he's looking at Alex, making $1,000, sitting on his ass, not even breaking a sweat in 1 hour. He's like, that's amazing. He wants that. We've been doing this so long sometimes, guys, that we forget. $200 a day is life-changing money, guys. And we tell people all the time, we do not sell the dream. That's the difference between us and everybody else. Do not quit your job. Do not quit your job. Keep your job. Supplement your income. Quit it when you're ready to quit, not because you want to. There's no reason to quit your job. By making supplemental income, this is what's going to happen. You will make enough money where you choose your job. You can now quit your shitty job and work for less money in a job you enjoy. That is what I did. I stopped chasing the money because I made supplemental income through trading to do what I want to do. That is the key. So when people say quit your job, do not quit your job. Doesn't mean to become miserable either. But when you make supplemental income and you have other sources of income, you can now choose your own happiness. Okay, guys? You can quit that shitty job you hate and go work wherever you want to work because you enjoy that work, okay? All right, guys, we'll see you back in the room. Text Tosh. We'll see you tomorrow at Tosh's webinar.